In the last video, we talked about the rate of change when you're moving with constant speed or constant velocity. Now we're going to talk about what happens when you're accelerating or decelerating, because things in the world speed up and slow down, and calculus has a way of tracking them. That's what we're going to talk about. So here's the story. You're driving down the road, driving down the freeway at 65 mile an hour road, but your speedometer is broken, and at 2 o'clock, you pass mile marker 175, and you see a cop aiming a radar gun right at you. And you're wondering, uh-oh, am I in trouble? Now, you got a passenger in the car, and the passenger happens to be compulsive. He takes notes like crazy. He's really great at math. He may need medical help, but in the meantime, you're going to make use of his talents. And he tells you that at 1 o'clock, you had passed mile marker 100. Now, can you figure out how fast you're going right now from those pieces of data? Well, not quite. You can figure out that in the last hour you went 75 miles. It took you an hour. So that meant that for the last hour you've been averaging 75 miles an hour. But that doesn't tell you how fast you're going right now. Then he checks his data and says, you know what? 10 minutes ago, we passed mile marker 164. So in the last 10 minutes, we've gone 11 miles. From 175 to 164 is 11 miles. 10 minutes is a sixth of the hour. So now, for the last 10 minutes, we've been averaging 66 miles an hour. And now you're feeling a little bit better, because the speed limit's 65, and well, maybe the cop will let you off easy. And then your friend tells you that at 155, we were at mile marker 169 3/4. So we've gone 5 1/4 miles in the last 5 minutes, and that works out to an average of 63 miles an hour. And then he works out how far you've gone in the last minute, that you've gone 1.02 miles in the last minute, and that means that for the last minute you've been averaging 61.2 miles an hour. For the last 6 seconds, you've been averaging 60.6 miles an hour. For the last 0.4 seconds, you've been averaging 60.06 miles per hour. Okay. For each of these things, if you know how long ago you were at a particular point, you can figure out how far you've gone, 11 miles, how long it took you, and what's the average speed. And you take the average speed over shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter periods of time, and now you get the average speed for the last 0.4 seconds. That's pretty much your speed right now. Your instantaneous speed is your average speed averaging over shorter and shorter and shorter periods of time. You take the limit as the amount of time you average over goes to zero, and it looks in this example that the limit is 60 miles an hour. Speed limit was 65, you're off the hook. Let's look at the same problem in pictures. So what you have is, if you plot where you are as a function of time, at time 2 you're at 175, at time 1 you're at 100. When we computed the average velocity for the last hour, what we were really doing is computing the slope of that line. You see, the rise is 75, the run is 100, and we got that the slope was 75. That's your average velocity for the last hour. When we did the average velocity for the last 10 minutes, we got the slope of this line. And we got that, you know, averaging over the last 10 minutes, we got that the slope was 66 miles an hour. And then we average over shorter and shorter and shorter periods of time. What we're doing is we're taking these two points that are getting closer and closer and closer and closer together, and these secant lines. A secant line is a line between two points on a graph. As the two points get closer and closer and closer and closer together, the secant line approaches a line that just touches the graph at that one point. This is called the tangent line. the slope of the tangent line is the limit of the slopes of the secant lines. So whenever we do this process, you're always looking at average velocities. You say, how far did you go in a particular amount of time? And that's the slope of a secant line. The instantaneous velocity, or the instantaneous rate of change, is the limit as you do this over shorter and shorter and shorter time periods. And that's the slope of a tangent line. The tangent line is what the secant line becomes in the limit. Now, I didn't show you how to take that limit. In the next video, we'll talk about how to actually compute this sort of limit and how to get an exact answer for an instantaneous velocity.